What's up, guys? My name is Brandon, and today Apple released iOS and iPadOS 14 Beta 6 to registered developers exactly 1 week after the release of Beta 5. So yes, we are switching to a 1 week cycle now, which is great. We should see a lot more stability be added in the coming weeks. But anyways, Apple also released tvOS 14 Beta 6 and also watchOS 7 Beta 6 to registered developers. And now that we have switched over to a 1 week beta cycle, we should start seeing the public betas being released on the same day as well. And that is the case with Beta 6. So it's out for both developers and for public beta testers. Taking a look at the size of this update, you can see here, much smaller as expected than Beta 5. We're at 438.2 megabytes on my iPhone 11 Pro here. And that size will vary depending on your device, but it should be under 500 megabytes. And Apple just says that it contains bug fixes, but that's why you guys watch my channel, because there's a lot more than just bug fixes. But anyways, let's go ahead and check out the build number for this latest update. Settings, general about 14.0. You can see there the build number for Beta 6 is 18A5357E. So we have an E at the end of the build number there. If we scroll down a little bit, we do also have a big new modem firmware update. So we went from 1.50.25 to 2.00.01. So that should be a nice improvement if you were having any type of connectivity issues. Connectivity has been fine for me, but I have seen some people complain about their connectivity on iOS 14 betas, but this new update, this new modem firmware should solve a lot of those issues. So now let's talk about what's new here in Beta 6. So first off, Beta 5 was great. So you guys saw my video where I said it's pretty much smooth sailing from here on out. And I still think that's going to be the case, especially now with the 1 week cycles. I don't think we're going to have anything near as bad as Beta 4, and Beta 6 seems to be, you know, lining up with what I said. So let's talk about some of the new features and changes here. And the first one is actually a pretty big one, and it has to do with the AirPods Pro and spatial audio. So if you have the AirPods Pro, if you go down to settings and then go to accessibility and then down to AirPods and then scroll all the way down to the bottom, you'll see we have a new toggle there for spatial audio, and it says follow iPhone. And if you read the little description below, it kind of gives you a brief description of what spatial audio is. So it says, when follow iPhone is on, audio for supported movies and TV shows will sound like it's coming from your iPhone instead of following your head movement. So this is a very awesome 3D audio type feature. And Apple talked about this at the Worldwide Developers Conference, but we never saw any hint of this coming until Beta 6. Now, we have the toggle here and you can turn it on and off, but it isn't actually working yet. So it's just a toggle. It's just basically for show, saying that Apple's working on it for now. I turned it on and off and listened to the movies and multiple things over and over again, and I cannot tell any difference. So I don't think that spatial audio is actually added yet. It's just kind of here inside of the settings now in Beta 6. So I think that we may have to wait until the final release of iOS 14 before we actually see spatial audio working properly with the AirPods Pro, and it's probably going to take an AirPods Pro firmware update as well. But it is cool that we now have a spatial audio toggle inside of settings here in iOS 14 Beta 6. Now, another change here in Beta 6 is inside of the clock. If we go to clock and then go to alarms and add a new alarm, as you guys know, in Beta 5, we got the scroll wheel back. But did you notice any difference here in Beta 6? Yes, the scroll wheel is actually more apparent now, which is exactly what I requested Apple to do in my Beta 5, both Beta 5 videos. I talked about how they need to make this more apparent that there's actually a scroll wheel there, and it looks like they listen. So here's Beta 5. As you guys could see, it's kind of just you click on it and you cannot tell it's really a scroll wheel. Now you get the little outline here and you could see the numbers, you know, behind it. So like you could see the 12 and the 13 more clear there in Beta 6, whereas in Beta 5, you really couldn't see the numbers behind it and there was no outline. So now it's more apparent that there is a scroll wheel and not just numbers that you have to manually type in. And I also found that typing in the numbers works a lot better than it did in Beta 5 as well. It's just more fluid and it seems to be a lot more polished than it was in any previous beta. So thank you, Apple, for listening on that one. Now, the next change comes with the shortcuts widget. So if you go to the plus right here and add in the shortcuts widget, let's go down to it right here. You'll notice that there is a little bit of change here. So let me pull it up on Beta 5 just to give you guys a better idea of the change. So on Beta 5, it just said favorites up top, and then it said quickly access your favorite shortcuts, and it said that for every single one of them. Well, now with Beta 6, it says shortcut instead of favorites, and also the description is slightly updated as well. It says quickly run one of your shortcuts instead of quickly access your favorite shortcuts. And then this also gets changed to shortcuts folder instead of just remaining as favorites. So both of these are the same there as well. So just some minor changes to the shortcuts widget. And speaking of widgets, that tall news widget that I showed you guys in beta 5 has been removed. Thankfully, that was pretty pointless. I mean, you could really only use it on the widget section. You couldn't even put it on your home screen. But now this is the largest one inside of news, and you can put it on your home screen. Also, if we go to delete an application in beta 6, you can see that the order has changed. So now delete app is up top, whereas it was on the bottom in beta 5. And then it's moved to app library and then cancel. So you can see there, it's reversed now in beta 6 when you go to delete an application. Also inside of the photos application, if you go all the way down on albums instead of other albums, it now says utilities right here. So that's where you'll see your hidden folder as well. If you do have the hidden folder enabled, which mine is currently hidden on both devices, but you can see there it shows the imports and the recently deleted now under a new category inside of photos. We also got this new splash screen inside of the maps application when you open it up for the first time here in beta 6. And you can see here it shows cycling navigation, curated guides, and speed camera. So basically just tells you about the new maps features in iOS 14. Also in beta 6, we get a fix for the airplane mode icon not properly appearing inside of the status bar. So now it always shows up in the status bar when you are in airplane mode. So in beta 5 and other previous betas, sometimes it would not show properly up in the status bar, but it seems to work every single time now. Also, when you're on the phone or you just get done making a phone call, it will actually show properly up in the top that the phone used your microphone instead of just saying unknown used your microphone. So I noticed this. I believe it showed this in beta 5 as well, but I didn't talk about it. So that's also here in beta 6. If you didn't see it in beta 5, that will be fixed as well, where it shows phone instead of just saying unknown as for what was using your microphone. And then Apple also mentioned that encrypted APFS files now appear in the sidebar inside of the files application in beta 6. And I'm sure there are additional new features and changes here in beta 6, but I've only been using the software here for a couple of hours, so I haven't been able to cover everything. But in my follow-up video coming on Saturday, I will talk about the new additional changes and features here in beta 6 that I did not cover in this video. So definitely stay tuned for that follow-up video. Of course, I do those every single Saturday. Now, I also wanted to discuss the Instagram bug that plagued a lot of people in beta 5. So I talked about this in my beta 5 videos, and that was where in Instagram, you could not post stories. So it would just show a black screen when you took a photo or when you selected a photo to post to your stories, it would just be completely black. However, that was fixed in a update for Instagram. So it did not take a new beta to be fixed. So Instagram did fix that. This is not new in beta 6, but you can now post to stories, and you can see there it doesn't turn black. It actually takes the photo and you can select photos as well. So thanks to Instagram for updating their application to support these iOS 14 betas. I also caught this little bug here in beta 6. So when I connected my AirPods Pro, take a look at the little text up top. So instead of saying my AirPods Pro connected, it just says center text, center content item. So basically just some placeholder code right there instead of actually showing my text, like my AirPods connecting. So that's a pretty funny bug here in beta 6. And I've actually seen a couple people have that as well. So hopefully that will get fixed. I'm sure it will in the next beta. Now going back to the bug fixes, there are actually a couple more bug fixes as well. So there were some things in beta 5 that got pretty annoying to me. And one of those was that you couldn't always select applications inside of the app library. So sometimes I would go to click on it and it just wouldn't click. I'd maybe have to tap it like 10 times and then it would eventually open up. But sometimes you could click for an hour and the application would not open up. But now in beta 6, it looks like everything is fixed and you can now go into every application, no problem. Also, another issue I ran into is when I would search for something. So if I just search for maps, sometimes the application would show up and then it would disappear and I wouldn't be able to click on it from Spotlight search, or I'd have to do it really quickly before it disappeared. But that has not happened here in beta 6, so I'm pretty sure that has also been resolved. There was also some keyboard lag in beta 5, so this didn't happen in every application, it didn't happen every day, but sometimes there would just be some stutter and some lag in the keyboard, but I've not had that one time here in beta 6, so that should also be fixed here in this latest update. And as for the clock and weather widgets, those appear to be fine for me as well. I've not really had any issues since the early betas, but some people still say that theirs is a little bit off, so if yours is still off, just remove the widget and add it again, and it should be fixed because I haven't seen any issues at all with the clock or weather widget over the past few betas. And if you guys want to read about additional fixes and workarounds, you can do so by looking at the release notes here. I will leave this linked down in the description below. Basically, it shows certain things that are resolved, known issues, and things like that here as well. So if you want to get into the nitty-gritty, you can go ahead and look at these. I will have this linked down in the description below. Now, as far as the performance goes, performance on beta 6, I would assume it's going to be exactly the same as beta 5, except with some added bug fixes and enhancements that may make it feel a little bit faster and a little bit smoother overall. But raw performance wise, I would expect beta 6 to be pretty much exactly the same as beta 5. I did also run a Geekbench test, and the scores were actually a little bit lower than beta 5. So 1330 versus 1338 and 3410 versus 3509. So just a little bit of a decrease there in performance according to the Geekbench scores. But of course, those don't always tell the whole story. And I will let you guys know how performance really is in the real world in my update video coming on Saturday. Now, as far as battery life goes, battery life is pretty much going to be the same situation as the performance. So battery life was fine for me in beta 5. It was actually an improvement over beta 4. And beta 6, I would expect the exact same. I would not expect any type of decrease in battery life. I would expect it to be about the same, if not a little bit better. So we'll have to wait and see on that. Of course, I will talk about battery in my upcoming follow-up video on Saturday as well. So stay tuned for that. And as far as if you should update, if you want to stay safe, just wait for that follow-up video so you guys can see my final analysis and, you know, everybody else's analysis as well, because I will talk about the community poll and things like that. So if you want to be safe, wait for that. But if you're on beta 5, I don't think it's going to hurt too bad to update to beta 6, just because I don't see any future beta being as bad as beta 4 was. And especially if we're getting a release every single week, I think the risk is a lot lower with updating now versus, you know, previous betas where you had to wait multiple weeks in between and you're kind of just stuck with that buggy software. So for most people, I think you're pretty much fine going ahead and updating to beta 6 now. But if you want to be on the safer side of things, just wait for my follow-up video on Saturday. Now, like I said, we are on a 1 week cycle, so we can probably expect to see iOS 14 beta 7 on September 1st. So that is next Tuesday, the 1st of September. That's when we can probably expect beta 7, if not the 1st, possibly on the 2nd. But Apple has been really liking these Tuesday releases, so I would expect September 1st for beta 7. But yeah, guys, that is iOS 14 beta 6. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, I would appreciate if you gave it a thumbs up. And of course, make sure you guys subscribe for a lot more iOS 14 beta coverage. And of course, iOS 14 coverage when it comes out to the public as well. So I do also have a lot of videos coming up soon that are not just iOS based. I know I've been kind of on a roll with these iOS videos, but I do want to pump out some more product based videos here as well. But anyways, that's for another time. If you guys have not joined the Discord server, that link is down in the description below. Go ahead and join that. We're always talking about things over there. And if you guys have not followed me on Twitter, go ahead and do that as well. That link is down in the description below. But anyways, guys, iOS 14 beta 6. Hope you guys enjoy this video, and I'll see you soon.